Bonjour and welcome to this mini reportage from the new outdoor field at FIRA 2023 in Toulouse. For some agriculture robots, the idea is crystal clear. Like this sewing robot and machine combination made by Softivert. This French robot will start in the soybeans and maize this year and expected to follow in 2024 at 5 different farms. Next up is the Exobotic robot, which may need a bit more explanation. It's intended to measure the tree circumference and more. It are important details for the farmer to determine growth action and the decision for the right harvest moment. Another robot that goes far beyond just one action is the pixel farming robot. With the scoop of the new model at the FIRA 2023, here you must think of a robot that is enabling intercropping. Within a larger community, from farmer up to research, they are in progress to develop the needed dedicated tooling. Also new is the T-Parts 350 from Digital Workbench. With a weight of only 350 kg, this is an extremely light vehicle. However, with a full hydraulic stabilization and an efficient four-wheel drive, it is capable to move smooth over the real agriculture fields. It's designed to run any existing tractor implement on the Category 1 3-point hitch. HairyBot doesn't need a lot of explanation. HairyTech is a family-owned company dedicated to deliver these decent machinery and service. With more than 10 machines already in the field, both sold and rented out, this machine did already show some proof. Besides drilling holes, also other implements are possible. It's a 25 horsepower engine. Next up are cameras to allow full remote control. A well-known brand and a familiar face at FIRA is NIO. While it seems just some further evolution over the last year, the real disruption is in the details. Within months, they expect to get legal authorization to operate also the larger robots fully remotely, meaning no on-site person is needed anymore. And that is of course also changing the perspective and the explanation of a business case for any agriculture robot. Not all is covered in this mini reportage. During the upcoming weeks, more will be updated on ducksize.com. On any question or suggestion, please let me know.